Hello, welcome back to the channel Awesome Learning. The next topic that we are going to discuss today here is reproduction of the kingdom fungi. As I told you in the previous video that there are three type of methods of reproduction, you can say modes of reproduction followed by fungi. One is vegetative propagation, second is asexual reproduction, and the third one is sexual reproduction. So I'll be just explaining you one by one with the help of these diagrams as you see here. The first one here is fragmentation, fission and budding. As you see here, as the word says, fragmentation, that means one organism or one cell gets divided into two fragments. As you see, it gets broken up from this portion and we get two different fragments. Now these fragments will develop the missing parts and will then behave as a new individual. Okay, so this is how the organisms divides by the help of fragmentation. Then we come to fission. As I told you, you have done this in case of amoeba also. So fission can also be seen in yeast, where the first karyokinesis takes place. Now what is karyokinesis? First, the nucleus will divide. You see, the nucleus is getting elongated. The contents of the nucleus are getting separated and then it divides. The nucleus, division of nucleus is called karyokinesis. After the division of nucleus, the cytoplasm also starts dividing, which is called cytokinesis, and the two cells are formed. Daughter cells are formed. This is fission in yeast. Third one is budding, as it is also seen in yeast. This is the mother cell. Suddenly a bud develops. Now how does this bud develops? The cytoplasmic content start moving to one portion. So jab cytoplasm will start moving to one portion, a bulge will be created. Now as soon as this bulge is created, the nucleus will start dividing. Okay, the nucleus will start dividing into two parts, and one of the part of the nucleus will move to the bulged part, and little bit of cytoplasm will also, the contents also will move to this bulged part, so that this bulged portion or this bud increases in size. And when this bud gets developed, fully developed, it can remain attached to the mother cell, or it can also detach from the mother cell, and wherever it will get a substrate, it will start its life, or it can form a chain of buds on it like this. A chain can be formed. This can also happen. So this is the example of fragmentation, fission and budding in yeast. Then we come to asexual reproduction. There are three methods of asexual reproduction as you see here. One is by spores. Now spores such as conidia, sporangiospores and zoospores, these are the examples here. You can see the first one is conidia. These are the conidia. Now you see, this is the well developed conidiophore. Conidiophore is a part of fungi that which will bear the spores, and here the spores are called conidia. Okay, so conidiophore is the part of fungi which will bear the spores. Here the spores are called conidia, and wherever these will fall, they will germinate. You see, they will germinate, and then mycelium will be formed. Hypha will form a network. The whole network is called mycelium, and then again one of the hypha gets the conidiophore, and the conidiophore will bear a lot of spores, and wherever it will fall, the new organism will be formed. So this is one example. Second one you can see here is again the same type, but here instead of calling them conidia, we call them as sporangia. Methods are almost the same as you see. Okay, so this is how you see spores grow. Here it bursts open. The sporangia will burst open. The spores are falling down. These are the spores which have fallen down. Now wherever these spores will fall, they will germinate and they will form. One will be male and one will be female, and they will form into hypha or mycelium, and later on they will grow up again. You can see they will grow up, sporangia again appears, and again it will form a new mushroom. As you see here, the cycle will go on. Third one is zoospores. Again, the zoosporangia is there. The zoosporangia is a part which will bear lot of zoospores inside. Now there will be a limit of filling the zoospores. After a limit, it will burst open. The zoospores will be released, and wherever these zoospores will find a place or a habitat to germinate, see, they will germinate, the germinating zoospores. Okay, and then it will form a new plant. So this is how asexual reproduction takes place in fungi. Then we come to asexual reproduction: oospores, ascospores, basidiospores. Now they are produced in distinct structures called fruiting bodies. As you see here, the fruiting body here, this is the fruiting body. So this is spores. These are the spores. Wherever they will fall, they will germinate. They will form a mycelia. Okay, these mycelia will then primordia, and then it will germinate into a fruiting body. Again, this fruiting body will have lot of spores. It will burst open. It will, the spores will fall. Okay, so here, children, you see there are two types of spores. One will be male, okay, and one will be female. Now why is it sexual? Because there are two types, hence they will fuse together and they will form a new organism. Then we come to ascospores. Here again, ascospores, dikaryotic hyphae or ascocarp. This is the fruiting body, and these fruiting body will bear lot of ascospores, which are then you can say they can start a new life wherever they fall. Then we come to the third type, is the basidiospores. As you see here, this is the basidiospore. Then again, two types of spores will be found. One will be female and the other one will be the male. And whenever they will get fused, they will again form a new basidiospore, which will be bearded on basidium. Basidiospore is the spore, and it will be bearded. That is, the fruiting body is the basidium here for sexual reproduction. Now here, three steps of sexual cycle. Children, very important three steps here for sexual reproduction are plasmogamy. Now what is plasmogamy? Fusion of protoplasm of two motile or non-motile gametes. Now remember that if it is sexual reproduction, so sexual reproduction will always take between the two different spores. One should be male and the other one should be the female. Now either both of them are motile, that is male and female both are moving and both are motile, or one is moving and the other one is not moving, or both are non-motile. It depends on different conditions. So what is plasmogamy? Fusion of protoplasm. That is, what is protoplasm? Cytoplasm plus nucleus. That is, all the contents inside the spore, cell of the spore, all the contents will get fused together, and that is called plasmogamy. Now plasmogamy, after that plasmogamy, actually we are talking about the fusion of both nucleus and cytoplasm. So then is karyogamy. What is karyogamy? Karyogamy is fusion of nuclei. That is, both the nuclei of both the cells will fuse together. Okay, now if the nuclei will fuse together, it will be N plus N, that is 2N. So two haploid will merge together or fuse together to form one diploid cell or nucleus. Then if it is a diploid, meiosis may occur. What is meiosis? Reduction, division. Okay, so meiosis in zygote resulting in haploid spores. Now let me explain you with the help of this cycle. It is quite easy if you pay attention. Now children, see here, this is a hypha. As I told you, hyphas can be septate or aseptate, that is coinocytic. And hypha together makes a mycelium, if you remember. Now, hyphas are of two types, plus and minus, that is male and female. there are two types of hypha. Now these hyphas, these will fuse together, that is plasmogamy will occur. Okay, plasmogamy occurs, the two hyphas will fuse. Now when the two hypha will fuse, there are two cells. Okay, both of them are having this nucleus. Okay, when plasmogamy occurs, these will fuse together. So what am I expecting? I will also expect that nucleus will also fuse together. If protoplasm is fusing, that means nucleus will also fuse. So plasmogamy is occurring, then karyogamy will also take place. And if karyogamy takes place, that is N plus N, what am I getting? I am getting a zygote, which is 2N. Okay, so this is 2N. Now, this zygote, wherever it will fall, it will give rise to some spores. And remember that spores are always N. Zygote is 2N and spores are always N, that is haploid. That means agar zygote se hi spores banne hai, to kaun si division honi chahiye yahan pe? Meiosis, reduction division hogi, tabhi to 2N se N spores banenge, right? So if we want to give rise to spores from this zygote, the division that will take place here will be meiosis, that is reduction division, and here the zygote will get reduced into a haploid spore. Now wherever this spore will fall, it will give rise to a new hypha. Okay, so this is how sexual reproduction will take place here. I hope this is quite clear. In sexual reproduction, two haploid hyphas come together and fuse. In some fungi, fusion of two haploid cells immediately results into diploid cells, that is 2N. Okay, then in ascomycetes and basidiomycetes, a dikaryotic or dikaryophase occurs. Now, what is this? This is quite different from the natural situation. What is this dikaryotic stage? Here, N plus N, that is two nuclei per cell. Matlab, there are two cells, okay? There are two cells, and in plasmogamy, what are we expecting? If we are expecting that these cells will fuse. Now, when these cells will fuse, I am expecting that the nucleus should also fuse. But dikaryotic stage is a stage where the cell fuses up. That is, cytoplasm will fuse, but the nucleus is not fusing. So at this point of time, cell has become one. Two cells have become one. Cell ek hai, but inside that cell, there are two nucleus. So this stage is called dikaryotic stage or dikaryophase, where one cell is having two nuclei. And such condition is called dikaryon. Okay, later on when the situation is fine or the conditions are favorable, these two nuclei will also fuse. Later on it will fuse and it will get converted into a diploid cell, right? But for a bit of time, or you can say for some time, the cell is in a stage where the cell is one but the nucleus it is having are two. So this stage is called dikaryophase. Okay, so this is about sexual reproduction, a different phase here as you studied the dikaryophase. Next, children, here is from fungi form fruiting bodies in which the reduction division will occur, leading to the formation of haploid spores. So I told you here there are so many types of fruiting body. Let me show you once again. These are the fruiting bodies. Here the fruiting body is this. Here it is ascocarp. Here it is basidiocarp. So there are different types of fruiting body which can bear spores, and all these spores are formed by the process of meiosis, that is reduction division.